We're back at Hammond Square, where there are a lot of exciting things going on, including the new store, Twirl by Obsession. Now, it's been here, part of the Obsession chain, you might say, because they now have three storefronts right next to each other here at Hammond Square. But there have been some big improvements, lots more stuff, and it's just exciting. We have many on hand for the Hammond Chamber ribbon cutting, including 7th Ward Marshal Pat Farris. And just hearing what this family, the Bangston family, has accomplished, I mean, it just makes you feel good.
It does. And with Stephanie being here, and I was talking to an old classmate of mine, Jimmy. He was here, and then I was like, "That's Stephanie Bogle. That's a young lady I graduated high school with." And for her to have this accomplishment, stay here in Hammond, and then create a business here, and I'm looking at one store across the way there, and she said that they had been here for almost 10 years, and so now they've made came just across the street, Twirl by Obsession, and it's doing a great job from what I understand.
You know, for women and girls, especially teenagers, to be able to shop for the dress for just that special occasion locally, yes, is such a godsend, because often in the past, they'd go to Mandeville, they'd go to Metairie, they'd go to Baton Rouge. Mm-hmm. Sometimes they'd go to all three looking for it. Absolutely. And now they can stay right here.
They can. And, you know, the prom dresses are here. I'm looking around the store. There's so many great looking gowns and dresses and things of that nature. So I'm sure all the young ladies are really going to enjoy it.
Well, Pat, you know, what everybody wants me to ask you is, are you going to run for sheriff? And let me just be direct and pop the question.
Mm-hmm. Well, it was not an easy decision to come to, I can tell you. A lot of support was out there that had asked. And I'd always told that I was going to take my time with this decision. I didn't run a formal poll or anything of that nature, but I have been asking individuals up and down this parish, would you like to see Pat Farris as your sheriff? And overall, like I said, it was not an easy decision to come to. But I have decided, speaking with my family over a lot of prayers, I will be running for 7th Ward Marshal again in 2026, and I will not be seeking election for sheriff in 2023.
Well, let me be honest. You know, the sheriff's race looks pretty wide open to me. But on the other hand, there are those who say the 7th Ward Marshal is one of the best jobs in Louisiana.
Well, I really enjoy it. I really do. And that was one of the decisions why I'm staying where I'm at. Yeah, I really enjoy my job.
Well, in the meantime, back on the farm, as it were, at the 7th Ward Marshal's office, what are you seeing in terms of crime, especially juvenile crime and so forth?
Well, you know, last time we interviewed at the flag-raising ceremony just right over here on July 4th, you know, I told them that the juvenile crime, it appeared, had toned down. And I think we're going in that direction. Our new judge, Britton Sledge, has, like I told you, has seen this and know that it's a huge concern to our community, and the large bond amounts that he's placing on some of these kids that are committing these dangerous crimes, he certainly recognizes that and are setting the larger bonds, which if that's what it takes, then that's what it takes.
So how about back to school, which is upon us? Are we prepared with the truancy programs and the other things that maybe are at the root of juvenile crime? Because a truant is on his or her way to failure. If we can catch them early, we can prevent a lot.
Well, education is an extremely important part of this whole process. As far as back to your question on the truancy, I do know that city court does have plans with Miss Alexa Hookfin to have that meeting, and as soon as they do, I've spoken with the clerk of court, and he's going to get with my office, and we're going to sit down, and we're going to come up with a game plan. But for a majority of what we do, the responsibility that we have for truancy hearings, I provide the security, city court provides the building, and then whatever else that it may take to keep these kids in school and to keep them off the street and, you know, keep them from committing these dangerous crimes is what we as city leaders and parish leaders and national leaders have to be concerned with.
It's just that here the late Judge Grace Bennett Gassaway pioneered in juvenile matters, but especially enforcing truancy, even calling in the parents if that's what it took. And then, of course, I said she passed away, but also we had the pandemic, virtual learning that made it really hard to enforce who's in school and who's out. So are we back now to sort of an even keel?
I think so. I think everything is moving in that direction, if not at 100% already. But it's going to be in person classroom, instruction now, and getting away from the virtual, I hope. And then that way we can keep more of a track on these kids and who's missing, school and who's in school. And if there is a problem at home, then it'll give the court system an idea of maybe what's happening at that point.
What else are you working on?
That's about it, Ken. Just steadily busy court dockets on Wednesday, which is our juvenile dockets. Our evictions are up. We've seen it go down, you know, shortly after COVID, and because we were under the moratorium at that point, evictions went down. We kind of spiked back up, tapered off, but now I think because of this inflation crisis that we're going through right now, we're seeing a huge increase in our eviction processes.
You know, that's interesting, and that's the first statistic I've heard locally that points toward a recession here.
Well, I mean, we can tell it, and that's the only thing that I can judge it by, and that's what I'm gauging it off of. I think maybe some of this financial situation that we're in right now is causing a lot of the uptick in these eviction processes.
Drive with confidence. From routine service to complete engine repairs, you can trust the pros at A1 Quick Oil to get you back on the road safely. Drop it off or sit and wait in customer-friendly comfort. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars, we fix them.